Yeah.
His face.
Oh, that's true. I have been known to crack mirrors.
That's not what I was thinking, but I guess that works. That might be a satisfiable way to explain the video feed. That or also when you're usually using two video feeds running together, it does kind of slow things down a little bit. I mean, I know even on my laptop, if I have the video feed going and someone else is also video feed on that on their end to show me their reaction, it is going to slow it down a little bit. Hmm. Not horrendously, but it does slow down.
And I actually do find it interesting that we're able to pick up the patrol report, since all the important info we get from that just talks about the C4 plastic explosive and detonator, which is only obtainable in Claire's story.
Yeah. That is curious. So does that mean Claire meta-gamed to get the explosive in this set?
Who knows? Two outfits. Well, of course, I'm going to change. I'm going to choose the biker one, but since I did not upgrade the gun yet, there is something I want to show off if we use this one. There we go. There's aiming gangster style.
Huzzah!
He turned it sideways. Kill shot! It's a kill shot!
Kill shot! Kill shot! It's a kill shot!
No, didn't scan anything. Yes, so now we change to our rough biker outfit. You never know. This could be a good outfit that preludes what he wears in RE4. Oh, sweet! He gets the gangster shot, too! Oh. That's too rich. Oh.
Well, that works out in our favor.
Yeah. Let's see, what other topics is there to talk about?
Toho.
That's a good point. And now that I'm back on the main computer, that means one thing.
Ah, yes, Denburu. Yay. Oh, speaking of which, GM, I did find an interesting Sakuya picture, but it is linked to a YouTube video, so I'll have to link you to the video rather than...
Too close for comfort.
Yeah, I'd have to link you to the video rather than the picture. However, it is also good Sakuya remix music, so I guess it's almost a win-win. Mm-hmm. Almost a win-win, I say. Because, well...
Oh, boy.
I'll just warn you that the remix has vocals in it.
Hey! Vocals.
Stop it.
Well, it's like Britney Spears-ish vocals.
No.
I'm not even really sure if it's... It's not like her voice... But it sounds kind of pop-ish, is all I will say. It's not bad, it's just... I looked at it and I was like, wait, Britney Spears inspired, or what? The description of the video, it just confuses me. That's all I will say. It'll be up to you if you want to see it, really. I'm assuming that's still a no, GM. I'll see if I can find the picture on Dan Boer, because it was an interesting one with, basically, I guess you could say, oddly shaped knives, reflecting Sakuya's, portrait, so to speak.
Well, pass me the link later on, and I'll have a look. I'm usually pretty good at finding stuff.
Yeah. That's pretty much why I was going to show you it, because the picture is really good. The vocal track? It's not exactly the most impressive vocal track, but it's definitely neat. I will say that much.
No reason for me to get that now, but if we want to save ourselves some time so we don't need to do this in the future, may as well do so.
Indeed. Yay, libraries!
Books.
Just be careful of which books you pick up, folks. Because if you pick up the wrong one, you might just get killed.
Yeah, two possible bad outcomes. Well, yeah, two. One, that she finds you and is in a huffing mood, and so she nukes you with a royal flail.
That's two, the best way to die.
That's the quick way.
Yep.
Two, you run into Kowakuma, and she hasn't fed in a while.
That's the other
slow way.
Yep.
Yeah, that's the slow way. It's fun, but you die at the end.
Yep. And it hurts more.
Depends on your definition. Hurt.
Some people would say it hurts more. Some would say it is more fun. Magnitude.
Oh, yes. I will take that small key gladly with open arms.
And then, of course, there's the even worse alternative. Hachi decides to open a trap door and drop you in the basement.
I'd almost say, yay, Flander, or?
Yeah.
Doesn't sound like it would be a yay. I don't know. It doesn't seem like a huge yay, but at the same time, it might be a yay. I don't know.
Depends on the kid's mood.
Yeah, if she's in a play with me mood, then you definitely will be let off easy.
Well, that depends on if you're boring or not.
True. And with Flounder, it's really hard to tell if you've managed to make her bored with you.
I'm glad I'm going back to this room. Because we got two things to show.
Bored, she makes you explode.
One. Already
okay,
know about.
Yeah, that's a fair point.
Handgun parts. And the other reason why I wanted to come back here. Subliminal product placement much?
Hey, look, it's Coca-Cola.
Always gonna eat you, always Coca-Cola.
Now, I'm saying subliminal product placement because the color's off, so it's not blatant product placement, whereas Parasite Eve 2, that was blatant.
Actually,
product placement.
There were blue Coca-Cola machines. I do remember old blue Coca-Cola machines. So, while it isn't exactly blatant, it is kind of a, it's a thing that we've not seen before. Yay! Freedom from being trapped in a sand tomb!
gonna put that to the side for now. You say anything about there being arguments made?
Yeah, I don't think we're really worried about that. Speaking of which, Pokemon Black and White version 2 actually is, as far as I'm concerned, it's going to look, it's going to be really awesome.
Hey, get down here. Thank you. He's been pecked to death. And each one of those holes he's been pecked in, there are bullets.
He got Hitchcocked.
The birds. Which is really funny,
and
because
we'll just
the
leave those birds alone.
Which is really funny in Alfred Hitchcock's movie The Birds, because the explanation for the birds being that crazy is magnetized fields made the birds somehow go haywire. Because birds have an inborn natural compass.
Yeah, birds are able to sense the Earth's magnetic field. When it goes haywire, due to solar storms, birds are not happy.
Now, let's see if I do this properly. It's going to be ammo waste, but if I do it perfectly, I say it'll be well worth the shells used. Leon, you broke the camera! Yes, if you aim the gun properly, it will leave bullet hole marks on the camera.
Yep.
Very fun, pointless but fun Easter egg.
It's a nice little Easter egg.
2, 3, 4.
Kill shot.
Well, yeah, I really don't see the point in killing them, especially since I'll need those bullets more effectively later on.
Fair enough.
More handgun ammo. An evolve handle. Why not? Just to make this interesting. Surprise zombie attack!
Surprise! It's zombies!
Huh. There were two officers, now they're gone. And now they're just Raccoon City citizens.
Raccoon City zombies.
You know, I know they're just zombies and therefore have little to no intelligence left, but would it be fair to say that they were done for the day and clocked out?
Probably.
I just had another hilarious thought.
What?
Considering the type of jacket he's wearing with the skull in the back, what if he accidentally dipped his head in the fire?
Well, then he'd be a true skinhead.
Dude, Ghost Rider.
That's what I was mainly heading towards.
That too? I was just thinking of the other end of the whole thing.
Well, now it's no wonder why Leon left the RPD. He wanted to become a superhero.
A superhero who causes... Well, who causes guilt. Or one of his superpowers is causing guilt.
I still can't get over how Ghost Rider was used to own Galactus.
Now, if only a particular Yama would be able to do that.
So now we did that. Combine for free ammo.
Or is she Kiyama, or is she...
Yes.
Yeah. So, yeah. Imagine if she was allowed to do that.
Yukari would be screwed.
So would Marissa.
Yeah.
There are two characters in Toho that would be totally screwed in that case. I think the only one who wouldn't be screwed in there is actually Sakuya. Because Sakuya isn't all that guilty of anything.
We don't know what she did for a living before she was picked up by Romelia.
Again, I think that's the only thing that leaves us as a question mark about Sakuya.
The general consensus is she was a monster hunter.
Belmont. Or
that's just popular fan speculation.
Yeah.
But if I remember correctly, canonically, she was a monster hunter. That's the popular theory in the universe.
Yep, which is just general monster slayer then at that point. Which, yeah, depending on how innocent some of the monsters might have been, she could have a ton of guilt. Depends entirely on what sort of purpose she was slaying them for. If it was just because they existed, then yeah, she's probably got a ton of guilt on her hands.
Let's see, leave it as is. Besides, I gotta get more. Yeah, I'm gonna get more healing items on the way, so I might as well just drop that mixer off.
Tackle.
You know, it's funny. I actually got Netflix about a few weeks ago for my PS3. I was able to order it by the time they had those October-only horror films out. So at least I got to see the first four parts of Friday the 13th. I was kind of hoping they had part 5, but apparently even Netflix says, no, that's not canon. That never happened. So it pretty much had all of them up to part 9, which I think was Jason Goes to Hell. I'm just gonna take this one.
Yeah, I'm sorry for not being at all that talkative, folks.
Yeah, you can go down now.
Been a little bit
as
more
I'm
sleepy
talking,
lately.
As I keep talking, I end up rattling out more drainage.
True. So I need to think of something else for us to talk about more, so that way you can keep getting this going. And getting our voices to get back closer to normal.
Oh, hello. Yeah. Not fast enough.
Not fast enough to nom your neck.
Oh.
He wanted some neck noms. What he got was a shoulder to the face.
Grab a few more herbs.
Yay, herbs! Oh yeah, actually, something Aizen and I had talked about earlier, GM.
Oh, yes.
Imagine what would happen if, after a few too many herbs, all of a sudden, I think it was like, we had Jill? Jill and Leon. Jill and Chris, or Jill and Leon? Jill and Chris, probably. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Jill and Chris
sitting there, and just before, like, I think it would be like, what was it again?
Hmm?
What were you describing the scene as? Like, just before, just after it, or just before death?
I'd say near the brink of death.
Yeah. Near the brink of death after having used at least several herbs to keep health up. Near the brink of it, all of a sudden they see a Katamari rolling by. Just as a final WTF moment. All of a sudden, Katamari rolls by just before the brink of... just before going out.
La 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 Katamari Tamashi.
You know, that's one way to dispose of the zombies. Have the prince roll them up into a star.
Yeah, that would be a really creative way to get rid of them.
And with that, Zombie Land has been created.
Yeah. Better yet, it wouldn't just be Zombie Land. It'd be Zombie World! Because the King of All Cosmos would make it into a planet.
No.
Just because he can. Because he'll pop it into the cosmos, and it'll create a planet. Or a star. Or something. We're not sure what. But he certainly will create something out of it.
Combine that.
Now Battletoads.
More like now. Flicker.
Hi.
You know, I just thought of something, GM.
What?
Even though I know it's Battletoads and not Battlefrogs, what if Suwako was capable of doing the same thing as the Battletoads do?
Beating the crap out of everything in a way?
No, I mean, like, creating giant ram horns, or a giant leather boot, or a giant fist as part of an attacking combo.
She could probably do that.
Seriously, it would literally be a battle of toads!
By the way,
at that point,
given where the liquor is right now, did anyone notice he was climbing on...
The
magic mirror that was non-existent now that he passed through it.
Yeah. Well, he was climbing on it.
He's climbing on nothing!
Well, was climbing on nothing.
Yes.
Again. I reiterate, it would be amusing to see Suwako as a sprite in a Battletoads game. Just because, I don't know, it would be amusing to my eyes.
Go to a quick item storage and just get the last remaining bit of items from there. That meant we got some herbs to drop off.
Yay, herbs!
There they are. A few of those to drop off. Well, we'll take care of that on the way. First, let's get that last bit of items from the other room.
Do-do-do.
What would happen if you combined Battletoads and Resident Evil?
An epic freaking game.
Resident Evil Toads.
Yeah. But again, Resident Evil and Battletoads makes Resident Evil Toads.
That would be interesting,
seeing as how your main methods of attack in Battletoads are punching and kicking.
I was saying mainly, it's a super hard game as it is. Imagine they're fighting super hard bosses from the Resident Evil games.
Oh, that would be just a bunch of dick moves right there.
Screw that.
Combine Battletoads hard difficulty with Resident Evil hard bosses. Oh boy, that's bad.
Do I want regular Coke or Coca-Cola? Or that famous line from Flight of the Navigator, well, it depends. Do you want new Coke, class Coke, cherry Coke, Diet Coke, or caffeine-free Coke?
Isn't there just Coke?
That's the thing. For those of you who didn't grow up in the 80s, there's this Coke. Back in the day, there was a ton of stuff that was called Coke. There's regular classic Coke, the new Coke, and of course the other Cokes that are still around. Cherry Coke, Diet Coke, and caffeine-free Coke.
Okay. So
it tells me if I use this in there, it's going to be pointless. Oh! Bullets. Not pointless at all.
Yay, bullets!
Because seeing as how I'm starting to run low on shotgun ammo, and the only bullets left in my handgun were already in the gun, yeah, I could use more ammo. And we're setting up for ClaireB. Enter the door of destiny. Oh, wait. Gotta go this way. Because now I can use that key to get rid of it. We should be fine.
Why did that sound like something from Legend of Zelda? Okay, I've officially found the Pokemon equivalent of Quick Man now.
Yay, they're all down. They're all down for the count. What's in there? Sure that doesn't surprise me. Pull that button here. Yay! More shotgun ammo. This lock. The lock is broken and can't be opened. No matter what you do or try, it's impossible to open. Unless, of course, you're either Jill Valentine, the quote-unquote master of unlocking, or if you're just Claire Redfield. Yay, so now we got a full orb. And I'm glad I have one shotgun shell left before reloading. Because we'll need it.
Need
to put this guy down in one shot. Goodbye, old buddy, who I only met a while ago. Ooh. You know what's the sad part?
You didn't even shoot him in the head?
I was trying to shoot for the head, and I accidentally got his crotch.
Ow.
So before he went to heaven, he got a small taste of hell.
Ow.
If you're still undead of sorts, I'm sorry! I didn't mean to shoot you there!
Well, he may not have been feeling anything at that point.
I can hope that's the case.
Welcome back, GM. So you missed Aizen trying to shoot him in the head.
And by which we mean him.
And instead shooting him in the crotch. By the way, I'm hearing echo.